I'm really starting to miss being around people I haven't seen in a while. It's hard to be away from people we care about. Today we're going to hear about a man who has a sickness called leprosy. And like the coronavirus, people were afraid of catching it. So he had to stay away from his family and friends. But Jesus helped him. And Jesus' power helps us when we're lonely too.
I wonder what's been the hardest thing for you about the whole coronavirus situation. For me, I miss school and my friends.
One of the hardest things for many people is not being able to see friends and extended family. For me, I miss my church family.
Being separated from people we care about can make us feel really lonely, but Jesus' power helps us when we're lonely. Today we're going to hear how Jesus' power helped a man in the Bible who was probably very lonely.
One way Jesus' power helps us when we're lonely is to remind us that Jesus is our friend. No matter what's going on right now, you always have a friend who is right there next to you, not 6 feet away. Let's sing a song about that.
Called Savior, have you heard of his perfect love? Have you heard of the one in heaven? Have you heard how he gave his son? Cause I have found this love, I believe in the Son. Show me your way, Jesus. You are my best friend, and you will always be. Nothing will ever change that, Jesus. You are my best friend, and you will always be. And nothing will ever change that. I believe in the one called Savior. I believe he's the risen one. I believe that I'll live forever. I believe that my King will come. Cause I have found this love, I believe in the Son. Show me your way,
wash our hands while we sing the ABCs. Ready?
ABC. people. That's called social distancing. We're being told that to stay safe from catching the coronavirus, we're supposed to stay 6 feet away from anyone else. Let's try that. Use your ruler or tape measure to make sure that everyone else in the room is standing or sitting at least 6 feet apart. We measured our yarn 6 feet before we started. People in Bible times knew all about social distancing. In fact, they were so afraid of catching leprosy, it was against the law for someone with leprosy to even come into the city. And if someone with leprosy was around other people, he or she had to call out, "Unclean, unclean," so everyone around them knew to stay away. No one wanted to accidentally touch someone with leprosy. All those rules must have made people who had leprosy feel pretty lonely. Let's try something. If I want to hug Olivia without losing our 6 feet apart separation, unless you have really, really, really long arms, you aren't even able to touch one another. No hugs, no pats on the back, just you and your own little bubble. Here's a question for you to talk about. How do you think it would feel to have to be this far apart from everyone for years? It could be pretty lonely to not be able to be close enough to hug anyone for a very long time. But let's see what Jesus did when he met someone who had leprosy. If you want to follow along in your Bible, look up Matthew chapter 8, verse 1 through 3. While Jesus walked along, a man with leprosy came up to him out of a crowd. The man knew Jesus had the power to heal his leprosy. So he said to Jesus, "Lord, if you are willing, you can heal me and make me clean." Jesus reached his hand out and touched the man and answered, "I am willing. Be healed." And the man was healed instantly. Wait, did you hear what Jesus did? Let me say that one more time. Jesus touched the man. This man probably hadn't had a hug or a pat on the back or anyone touch him at all for a long time. Then Jesus touched him. Jesus wasn't afraid of getting leprosy. Jesus knew his power was greater than any disease, leprosy, or coronavirus. Jesus knew that not only did this man's body need healing, his heart needed healing too. This man needed to feel Jesus' love right there on his arm, on his shoulder, or even his head. He needed a loving touch to heal his loneliness.
We need to be wise and protect ourselves from sickness right now, but being separated from people can make us feel lonely.
Here's something I want you to think about. Who do you know that might be feeling lonely right now? How can you reach them? We can reach out to help others when they're lonely, but even when no one else is around, Jesus' power helps us when we're lonely. He's always right there with us to comfort us and heal our hearts. Let's watch this video about Jesus healing the leper.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. No one can serve two masters, for either he will hate the one and love the other, or else he will be loyal to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and mammon. Therefore, I say to you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or what you will drink, nor about your body, what you will put on. Is not life more than food, and the body more than clothing? Look at the birds of the air, for they neither sow nor reap nor gather into barns, yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not of more value than they? Which of you, by worrying, can add one cubit to his stature. So why do you worry about clothing? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin, and yet I say to you that even Solomon in all his glory was not arrayed like one of these. Now, if God so clothes the grass of the field, which today is, and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, much more clothe you, O you of little faith. And the rain descended, the floods came, and the winds blew and beat on that house, and it did not fall, for it was founded on the rock.
Lord, if you are willing, you can make me clean.
I am willing. Be cleansed.
Ready?
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
All done. Now stop and take a look at our mixture. We've mixed it up really well, but let's see what happens as it settles down. While we're waiting to see what happens, what do you miss most about being separated from others right now, Diana?
I miss getting to hang out with my friends and laugh and have fun.
Me too.
A few moments later.
As the mixture settles down, it doesn't look like the oil and water are really mixed. It seems like the oil and water want to stay separate. I think they're practicing social distancing. Oil and water naturally want to stay separate, but it isn't so natural for us. Being separated from others can make us feel lonely, but we can turn to Jesus for help because Jesus' power helps us when we're lonely. Even though we're separated from a lot of our friends, we still have our family here with us, and we can still connect with people online and even do online Sunday school together. If it's healthy for you, go ahead and gather with your family for a nice, big group hug. And if it's not safe to hug someone right now, try giving a long distance hug like this. And thank Jesus for each person in your family by name. Focusing on the people that Jesus has put in our lives, even in this hard time, can help us feel less alone. That's one way Jesus' power helps us when we're lonely. Before we leave today, we want you to spend some time with Jesus. You can sing along with the song or sit down and talk to God, but do your best to shut everything else out and keep these few minutes just for the Lord.
Dear Lord we thank you for this time that we get to be together and that we get to reach you guys through video. And we pray that you would bless each and everyone watching this, and that you would bless all of the sick people, God, that you would heal them. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
We miss you kids a lot. While we may get to see some of you Sunday in the sanctuary, remember to be safe and practice air hugs and air high fives today. Along with air hugs and air high fives, you can even come up with a social distancing handshake. This light of mine.